You wanted the best, and you got the best. The hottest band in the world.
Black Sabbath.
Schmackamagab, it is Black Sabbath Sunday, and King Dinosaur brings you a track-by-track album battle with Born Again by Black Sabbath versus 1984 Van Halen. I love both these albums. I will say, out of the six-pack, 1984 is my least favorite. I even like Diver Down more. For me, my favorite Van Halen albums are in order. My favorite is 1, then 2, then Women and Children First, then Fair Warning, then Diver Down, then 1984. I love 1984. Don't get it twisted. Let's cut the deck. Now, Born Again. Oh, my God. It is my favorite Black Sabbath album without Ozzy. And I love the Dio stuff. Again, let's cut the deck and don't get it twisted. There's something so special about Born Again. And I'm even talking about the sound. I know everybody's going crazy because they found the master tapes and everybody's, oh yeah, Tony, go fix it, go fix it. And I'm for him going to fix it, whatever, I'll buy it. But I really doubt it's going to beat the production Born Again has now. The grimy, low, I don't know, man. It just matches the music perfectly. I love the bad production, just like I love the bad production on Hotter Than Hell. I think it adds charm to it. And I think this album is awesome. Number one, because of the songs. And number two, because of the sound. That's right. I love the sound of this album. I have no problem with it. So let's get this started, all right? We got Trashed versus 1984. Now, when it comes to Van Halen's six-pack, it's a perfect discography. But I gotta tell you, there's only one song I dislike out of all those six albums. Only one. I love every other song. And that's 1984. I just don't like it. I'm giving that to Black Sabbath. All right, next. Stone Age versus Jump. All right, Stone Age is a little instrumental and blah, blah, blah. I love it, man. I was listening to it today, actually. I put on Born Again today. And I love the sound of this and the Dark. I love those two instrumentals. They're fucking awesome. I also love Jump. I know a lot of people don't love it. The keyboards, this and that. I love it. And I think what makes the song to me is David Lee Roth, man. His vocal sounds, his lyrics. I think it's pure Dave. And Dave, to me, is definitely the VIP on this song. Not Edward's keyboard wizardry. No, to me, it's all about Dave when it comes to the song Jump. And I'm giving it to Jump. All right, next. Disturbing the Priest versus Panama. I'm giving that to Black Sabbath, Disturbing the Priest. Now, like I said before, there's no songs I dislike from the six-pack. But I got to be honest with you. Panama, while I like it, I don't love it. If I were to make a ranking of all the Van Halen songs, this would be kind of low there. By the way, I said Van Halen, not Vangina. If it was Vangina songs, it'd be number one. But yeah, it's like whatever. I like it. I don't love it. I'm giving that to Black Sabbath. Disturbing the Priest. All right, next. The Dark versus Top Jimmy. Like I said earlier, I dig The Dark. It's awesome. It's moody. It's weird. I love Top Jimmy, though, man. I got to give that one to Van Halen. Top Jimmy, he's the king. All right, next. Zero the Hero versus Drop Dead Legs, both awesome. Love them both. Drop Dead Legs is such a... it's a deep track. It's a song they did not play on the 1984 tour, yet they did play it in 2015. When I saw Van Halen for the very last time. Rest in peace, King Edward. I got to give it to Zero the Hero, though, man. Yeah, I like it a little more. All right, next. We've switched the album around. And we got Digital Bitch versus Hot for Teacher. I love them both, but my favorite song off this album, 1984, is Hot for Teacher. To me, it's the most classic Van Halen sounding song. You know, I've never witnessed anybody out there say that Hop for Teacher is the best song off 84. Does anybody think that? Because if you do think Hop for Teacher is the best song off 1984, leave it in the comments. If you don't think it, hey man, I don't give a fuck what you think. You obviously don't like classic Van Halen if you're not going to put Hop for Teacher as your number one. I'm just kidding, kind of. All right, I'm going with Hop for Teacher on that one. All right, next, Born Again versus I'll Wait. This one's kind of difficult, I'll admit it. And because I love Born Again, but I got to go with I'll Wait. You know, a lot of people are like, oh, you don't like the Sammy sub because it got keyboards. Well, 1984 had I'll Wait and Jump. And I love them both. I love I'll Wait even more than Jump. And that one's even more synthesizers, whatever the fuck. Love Alex's choice of drumming on it. Love Dave again, his lyrics and voice. David Lee Roth rules, and Sammy Hagar sucks. I'm giving it to I'll Wait. All right, next. Hotline versus Girl Gone Bad. Ooh. Yeah, this one's really hard. I am barely giving it to Hotline. Barely. God, I love that song. All right, then we end it with Keep It Warm versus House of Pain. I love them both, but again, man, I got to go with Van Halen on this one, man. House of Pain is fucking awesome. And so King Dinosaur, this is the final score. There you go, buddy. You got more track by tracks. I want to thank you, my friend, for your track by track donations. Just to let you guys know, there are more things he wants me to do. I probably put this one up already. He wants me to put Orgasmatron versus Wendy O. Williams' Wow album. He wants me to put Rage for Order, Queensryche versus Time Will Tell by Fifth Angel. He wants me to put Fourth Century, Uncertain Future versus Venom at War with Satan. And then the last thing he wants me to do, and I'm going to make this King Dinosaur into three separate episodes. He wants me to put my top 10 AC/DC songs with Bon Scott and my top 10 AC/DC songs with Brian Johnson. And I'm going to separate them. I'm going to make one episode for each. And then he wants me to put a track-by-track album battle against my favorite Bon and Brian songs. So I'll make that the third episode. Thank you so much, King Dinosaur. You got more coming up. You rock, my friend. And everybody watching now, you all rock as well. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Do it today on Black Sabbath Sunday. I'd do it any day. And, hey, like the video. It's good for the YouTube algorithms. So stay frosty. Listen to Black Sabbath. And smack 'em a gob.